Because in these ups and downs through life, you you know that, well, tomorrow I'm going to feel better, the sun will be shining, and so on. But when you're in this type of depression I speak of, it doesn't matter whether it's a black of night or whether the sun is shining or anything else, nothing looks good. It's all blackness.
May not know is that I have suffered with anxiety and panic attacks really, really badly.
I'm depressed.
Today I want to talk about my anxiety.
Other things that I also struggle with are OCD, panic attacks, PTSD, insomnia, paranoia, and irrational fears.
But I also have anxiety.
What's up?
God dang it.
If you suffer from anxiety, make sure you like this video, leave a comment down below saying, oh my God, love you, subscribe, and join the anxiety fam.
Hey, what's up you guys, it's me Luke and welcome back to another video, or if you're new here, welcome to my channel. So today's video is another commentary video. I've said it before and I'll say it again, I only do these videos when I'm really passionate about a topic, and today's video is no exception. Today we're going to be venturing into more of a controversial topic, and that topic being mental illnesses. But before we get into it, let's go ahead and travel a couple of decades into the past. Many years ago, mental illnesses were a taboo topic that were not discussed, and those who suffered from them were often misunderstood and not given the help that they needed. People with anxiety were often told the age-old saying that is still said to this day, to just stop stressing and just relax, as if that ever worked. And people with depression to stop being so negative, as if it was just a switch in your brain you could just turn on and off. Some cases, people with mental illnesses were just deemed crazy and thrown into institutions where they had to endure many cruel treatments. Now, we're not gonna sit here and dwell on the past because honestly, I don't feel like talking about lobotomies and electric shock therapy more than you probably feel like listening to it. So we're gonna talk about today, the 21st century. Now, things have obviously changed over time, thank God. And while it is great that people are being educated about mental illnesses and that the stigma surrounding them are starting to fade away, with the introduction of the internet and the growth of social media, many issues have arisen, one of which being the romanticization of mental illnesses, which by definition, according to our trusty friend Google, word romanticize is when you deal with or describe something in an idealized or unrealistic fashion and make something seem better or more appealing than it really is. And now that that's out the way, we can get into what today's video is all about. So the other day I was scrolling through Instagram when I came across something that inspired me to make this video. YouTuber Karina Koff made this post with the caption, "Anxiety sucks. New drop, link in bio, donating 15% to the Anxiety and Depression Association of America." This is a post promoting her new merch, first one being a black t-shirt that says, "My anxieties have anxiety," and the second being a beige hoodie with the literal Google definition of anxiety printed on the back of it. Yeah, you really can't make this stuff up. Now, through a lot of extensive digging, I did find a few positive comments on the post, with users saying things such as, "This drop is rad. We love a caring queen." But through looking through the comments, it didn't take long to notice that majority of people were unsurprisingly not too thrilled with this. With comments such as, "You really out here trying to profit off mental illnesses? Stop glamorizing anxiety. This illness has ruined my life and you making a profit off of it is sick. To be honest, we should talk about anxiety, but we shouldn't make it some form of a fashion statement or make it trendy. This to me feels very disrespectful and I don't like how others are okay with people merchandising it." I honestly couldn't agree more. For one, she's literally profiting off of people's mental illnesses with the way that this is marketed because it is obviously aimed at consumers with anxiety. And what I think Karina doesn't understand is there is a distinct difference between marketing to a certain demographic and providing a sense of relatability under the guise of spreading awareness when really it's just to make a sale. And look, maybe I could give her a pass if all of the profits were being donated to a non-profit organization. I already know what some people are thinking.
But Luke, she said she was going to donate some of the proceeds to the Association of Anxiety and Depression of America.
But she said she was only going to donate 15% of the proceeds. And while donating to charity is usually commendable, question whether or not she did this just to paint what she's doing in a positive light. Because if people get mad at her, then she can just rebuttal them and saying
the proceeds are going to a good cause.
But let's focus on the facts. 15% of the proceeds are going towards a good cause. Where's the other 75% going? Straight into Karina's bank account for her to spend on whatever she pleases. She's indirectly profiting off of her followers' anxiety, and I don't think she understands how completely immoral that is, because if she did, she wouldn't have made it in the first place. Now, I think this user's comment really sums up what I'm trying to say, so I'm just gonna go ahead and read it to you. She says, "Making and selling your merch about anxiety isn't going to help at all. If you want to help, why not make a donation to a reputable company that actually helps with mental health with the money you make off of this merch? You could even make a video talking about mental health. Start a discussion that's not based on your clothing line. Get people talking and informed without having to make money and unfortunately glamorizing mental health. Not everything has to be about merch and money. You have a massive platform you could use for much better than a black t-shirt saying your anxiety has anxiety. Feels like such a waste." And honestly, I totally agree. I don't think these influencers understand the amount of influence that they have with these platforms that they have. Your title of your job is literally an influencer. You have have influence over people. So you need to go ahead and think about everything you're doing and think that you are actually having a good influence on people. And this merch scandal is a prime example of influencers not using their head. Now let's go ahead and give Corinna a little break because I think I got my point across. But on the other hand, I genuinely don't understand why anybody would buy this, let alone wear it in public. Now just so you understand my point of view and don't think I'm some random who doesn't understand the topic that I'm talking about, I have actually been diagnosed by a psychologist with an anxiety disorder. So I feel like my opinion on this topic is somewhat relevant. Now while I think it's great to start a discussion about mental illnesses and get rid of the stigma and really spread awareness about it, I don't think having a mental illness is anything to be proud of. Now don't get it twisted, I'm not saying having a mental illness is anything to be ashamed of, but why would you be proud of something that negatively affects your life? I don't want anxiety, I wish I didn't have anxiety, but I do, and that's okay, but it's not something I'm proud of or something I'm happy to have, let alone something I want literally written on my body for the world to see. See, what I don't understand about even creating this merch for people to wear is people with anxiety don't like drawing attention to themselves, let alone drawing attention to the fact that they have anxiety. So why would someone who suffers from it want to make a fashion statement out of it? The entire thing just baffles me, to completely honest, and I can't think of a legitimate reason as to why Corinna would make this merch other than the fact that she romanticizes mental illnesses or she's just looking for a quick buck. And maybe neither of those things are her reasoning behind this, but her actions and the mere fact that she even came out with this merch certainly make it seem that way. But to be fair, Corinna is not the only perpetrator of romanticizing mental illnesses, nor is she the only one who profits off of them. In the recent years, it has become a questionable trend for companies to start selling products that romanticize mental illnesses.
Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh wow.
In the recent years, it has become somewhat of a trend for people to have mental illnesses such as anxiety, with people often publicly proclaiming they have them any chance they get. We've all seen the memes and funny anecdotes going around on social media about anxiety and depression, and almost everyone seems to be sharing them. Some people even go as far as romanticizing depression, self-harm, and suicide. But do all these people sharing these posts actually suffer from a mental illness? Were they actually diagnosed by a psychologist? Most likely not. But it has become somewhat of a norm on social media for people to have a mental illness such as depression or anxiety. And I believe that this is mainly due to the romanticization of mental illnesses on both social and mainstream media. For example, internet users will make memes about anxiety, rappers will write songs about depression, and artists' works will often be inspired by various mental illnesses. And while these things are not inherently bad, where do we draw the line as to what is awareness and what is influence? A huge example of this issue is the popular TV show 13 Reasons Why. Now, I'm sure all of you have watched it, it's really popular on Netflix, but if you haven't, the show covers the story of Hannah Baker, a girl who commits suicide, and after her death, 13 tapes are found, each a chapter in her reasoning for committing suicide and each about a specific person and how they had done wrong by her and ultimately led to her decision to take her own life. Now while the show did cover a range of serious taboo topics and bring a lot of awareness to them and bring the conversation about them to the forefront, and it really did handle some of those topics really well, I don't think it's without fault. While I think it's great that the creators of 13 Reasons Why showed how detrimental someone's suicide can be on everybody that they leave behind and all of the devastating and negative effects that it has on those people, I think having the girl who actually committed suicide present throughout the show in present time is extremely problematic. Because it sends the wrong message. If you actually commit suicide, then that's it. You're gone. You're no longer there. You cannot see what happens after you are gone. Say somebody committed suicide because of a bunch of horrible things that somebody did to them. Obviously, that's really sad. But unlike Hannah Baker's story, they don't get to see the effects of their suicide on those who wronged them. And I know this is a really controversial topic to talk about, but the tapes almost make it seem as if this was somewhat of an act of revenge. Now, in no way, shape, or form am I trying to minimize the pain that Hannah went through. And obviously, she went through a lot of horrible things. If you watch the show, you know. But she wouldn't have left the tapes behind if she didn't want the people who did these things to her to feel bad. Now, obviously, there are some characters in that show who did horrible things to her, but there are other characters who are just being teenagers. Teenagers are flawed. They make mistakes. They're growing up. They do dumb stuff. We all did dumb stuff when we were teenagers. It doesn't mean that if you did something to hurt somebody that you should be one of the reasons they committed suicide. I just think that the show, in terms of the tapes, kind of sends a wrong message, but you know what? That's just my opinion. We all have one, and that's mine. Now, don't get it twisted. I'm not saying that the show romanticized suicide. I'm just saying that the way that they depicted it can kind of give people with suicidal thoughts the wrong idea. And just to really make it clear, I'm not talking about the actual act of her committing suicide, because obviously that scene was really graphic and I don't think it was romanticized in any way, but I'm saying the effect of her suicide, how people felt horrible about it, and it was almost sort of like a weird twisted act of revenge. I'm not sure if that's what they were going for, but that's certainly how it came across to me and quite a few others based on what I've read. Now, going along with that giving that wrong idea to the viewers thing, the show had another thing that I found really problematic. They had this character who, when questioned as to why she harmed herself, said, "It's what you do instead of killing yourself." Now, this is clearly problematic problematic because it sends a message to people with suicidal thought that they should just harm themselves instead, when in fact there are many other healthier ways of dealing with suicidal thoughts. Now my point with bringing up all this is that the media really needs to be careful with what they portray and ask themselves if they are spreading awareness or if they are indirectly having a negative influence on their viewers. Now moving on from mainstream media, a notable example of the romanticization of mental illnesses in social media comes from the internet's very own black hole, Tumblr. Now Tumblr is kind of dying and I'm not entirely sure what it's like now that it's under new management. Now back when I was on Tumblr, it was really difficult not to come across posts or artwork that were romanticizing mental illnesses or self-harm or suicide. Now I begrudgingly went ahead and dug up some examples to show you guys, but if you're really sensitive to topics such as suicide, depression, anxiety, and self-harm, I urge that you go ahead and skip to this timestamp as I wouldn't want to trigger anyone. But yeah, let's just go ahead and look at some of these examples. So I found this post and it says, destroy yourself and see who gives a fuck. So this goes along with kind of that idea of revenge, of inflicting harm upon yourself to kind of make people feel guilty for something that they did to you. Obviously not everyone who self-harms does it, but it just puts that idea into people's head, especially impressionable teenagers. Once again, this one says, her eyes ran out of tears to shed, so she forced her skin to cry instead. Now this is just a prime example of romanticizing mental illnesses because it's literally a poem about self-harm. Now crying is often seen as something that is beautiful. Like people will always like on Tumblr and stuff post pictures of like girls crying and it's like an aesthetic thing. So saying that when you cut yourself, it's like your body crying or something, that's just really twisted and messed up and sends such a wrong message. And it's just a prime example of how bad romanticizing mental illnesses can get. Now here's one about suicide. It says, I wasn't trying to kill myself, but I knew that if I had gone too far, I wouldn't care. Not really sure what a picture of some girl's legs with a pair of Adidas has to do with this, but regardless of that, once again, just kind of romanticizing that idea of suicide. I understand trying to make a relatable post, but don't make relatable posts about suicide and self-harm because that is a really, really, really sensitive topic that you really don't want to be making artworks or posts or relatable things about because you do not know who out there is really impressionable who is going to see that and take that as an influence to possibly do something to themselves. Oh, that's funny. Look what I came across. Here's a post of a little boy that says, my anxieties have anxieties. That sounds so familiar. Oh yeah, Corona's merch. Now honestly guys, that is not even the half of what is on the internet. There are way worse posts out there, but obviously I wasn't gonna go ahead and put that on here, but I just wanted to kind of give you an idea as to how some of these twisted posts that are on social media romanticize mental illnesses, self-harm, and suicide. Now not all posts on social media about mental illnesses are that intense. Like I said before, most posts on social media about mental illnesses are just relatable tweets or funny memes. And I just like to say that while I understand that making jokes about one's mental illness can often be a coping mechanism for people, I'm also very wary about how self-deprecative humor and posts about one's mental illnesses can affect other people. Some who are making these posts could just be doing it to seem quirky or relatable or just to get attention in the form of likes, views, and retweets. Which, when living in a time where so many of us seek validation and attention from social media, isn't that far of a stretch. But what people don't often think about is how this, accompanied with the depictions of mental illnesses in media, often leads to people self-diagnosing and using their illnesses as a way of being relatable or funny or a way of garnering attention or sympathy. Now don't get it twisted, I'm not saying that everybody who claims to have a mental illness is like this. All I'm saying is that the number of people who are like this are starting to rise. More and more people are starting to romanticize mental illnesses without even realizing that they're doing it. Now, in terms of stopping this, there's only so much we can do. We can't control what the media portrays, nor can we control what people post on social media, nor can we control people who try profiting off of mental illnesses. But what we can control to a certain degree is our own thoughts and actions. All I can say is don't self-diagnose yourself, go see a psychologist, and then they can actually clinically diagnose you with a mental illness if you have one and give you the proper treatment and help that you need. Because contrary to a lot of people's beliefs and actions, social media is not your therapist. Now, while there's nothing wrong with making a relatable tweet or sharing a funny meme about a mental illness that you struggle with to help you cope, before you do so, ask yourself why you're doing it. Does this spread awareness? Are you doing it for attention? And could this have a negative effect on somebody else? Now look, don't get it twisted. I'm not trying to tell you what you can and can't post. All I'm saying is I think that we could all put a little bit more thought into what we put out into the world. Alrighty guys, that's it for me in this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you found it interesting or entertaining, or anything along those lines, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up and share it so we can go ahead and spread this message. I'd love to hear your thoughts down in the comments below and for us to all start a healthy conversation with one another. And if you're new here, please go ahead and make sure you subscribe for new videos every single week and make sure you turn on that post notifications bell so that you never miss an upload. If you'd like to see more commentary videos from me, please let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to watch some of my other commentary videos, I'll go ahead and link it in the card above me and in the description down below. And yeah, that's it for me in this video, guys. I really hope to see you in my next one and I hope that you have a great day or night wherever you are in the world. Bye!